Let the show begin. Bonsoir à tous et à toutes. Good evening, everyone. Puis-je avoir votre attention? May I have your attention, please? Thank you. Alors, bonsoir et merci d'être des nôtres pour les prix MITAX 2021. Je m'appelle Véronique Morin, je suis journaliste scientifique, productrice numérique et j'ai un énorme plaisir d'être avec vous ce soir en personne. Fantastique. Before commencing our festivities, I would like to begin by acknowledging our event is taking place on the traditional unceded territory of the Algonquin and Anishinaabe peoples. I would also like to take a moment to assure everyone watching at home that those of us who are here present, that we have all provided proof of double vaccination. Per the Ontario's government public health measures to limit the spread of COVID-19, we kindly ask you to keep your mask on unless you're eating and drinking, of course. Lastly, while we are very glad to be here in person, we are also aware that we're not over the woods yet when it comes to the pandemic. Therefore, as a courtesy, we ask all presenters and award winners to keep a certain distance and elbow instead of shaking hands. Pour ceux et celles qui nous écoutent en ligne, à la maison, bonsoir. Vous pouvez activer donc les sous-titres en anglais et en français, français, anglais. All of you can now follow us also tonight on Twitter via the hashtag MITAXAwards et en français hashtag PrixMITAX. Maintenant, passons aux festivités. J'ai le grand honneur de vous présenter l'aînée Claudette Comenda, de la nation algonquine, a prononcé quelques paroles pour nous.
Kwekakina. Bonjour tout le monde. Hello everyone. Well, let's have some good energy in this room. It's been a long time that people have come together, right? So we are here together to celebrate another year of success of MITAX, all the individuals and research, business, education. So once again, I'm going to say good evening, everyone. Good evening. I love it. I love it. You need to have that energy to bring that motivation and inspiration, especially to the award winners. And everyone hearing your energy certainly is very inspirational, especially to all of you, the award winners this evening. All of you who are involved with MITAX, it's so important that we acknowledge, we recognize, and we celebrate the successes of education, of business, research, and everything and anything that we do in that field certainly does contribute to make today and tomorrow a better place for the children, because you are all role models for the children. I'm very honored to be here to bring greetings on behalf of my people. Miigwech kibija yego ma anishinaabe yikiu mamaweniniwag. Kani mich kijigun kinun indishna kasketagan zibi donjiban. Bevenu. Bevenu a tous. Bevenu au territoire non cédé de mes ancêtres, la nation algonquin. Je suis toujours très fier pour donner des mots à bénédiction et aussi pour donner des mots à bevenu. I'm always honored on behalf of my nation, on behalf of my ancestors who have been here since time immemorial, to greet each and every one of you, to welcome you into this beautiful, unsurrendered homeland of the Algonquin people. My name is Claudette Comenda. I was born and raised in my community of Kitigan, Zibi, and Anishinaabe Algonquin First Nation, which is about 100 miles north of here on the Quebec side. But this is the territory, the ancestral territory of my people. And I'm always honored to represent my ancestors and to represent my relatives, to represent my children and to represent my grandchildren and to represent those seven generations that will come. Bonjour, monsieur. Bonjour. The responsibility that we have as we welcome visitors into our homeland. We also must acknowledge the first ancestors of this land, my ancestors. I acknowledge the ancestors of other indigenous peoples, as I acknowledge all your ancestors as well. It is important that we never forget where we come from. It is important to know that we all have ancestors and never forget. Never forget the wisdom and the knowledge, the sacrifice, the kindness and the love that they had for us, and they continue to guide us. The responsibility that we have as Anishinaabe people is we welcome people to our territory, even if those visitors are from other indigenous nations. Then we acknowledge our ancestors, and then we bring blessings. And so I say to you, my brothers and sisters and family and friends, I acknowledge the Creator, and I ask the Creator to bless each and every one of you beautiful people with the work that you are doing, your families, your friends, your relatives. And I say, Chimi Gwej Gishiminado Kinakego Mi Gwej. Nibuk Sendam Gishiminado Onje Kakina. Nibuk Sendam Mashkawiziwin. Nibuk Sendam Zagiediwin. Nibuk Sendam Minopomatswin. Migwej Gishiminado, Migwej Onje Ninuin Namia Win Onje Kakina. Nibuk Sendam. And Nabagis, we doko wadaduin, onje nongo meshishwabang, onje kakina. And Creator, I raise my voice, my heart, my spirit to you in this language, English, as I said, in the language that you've blessed me with, Anishinaabe Moin. The prayer that I offer for all who are here. Continue to bless each and every person with that good life. Bless them with strength, courage. And may they continue to walk in the path of kindness and friendship and strength. And Creator, together as brothers and sisters in this beautiful circle, I pray that everyone comes to know, understand, and embrace those seven grandfathers that you have blessed us with. The grandfather of love, wisdom, respect, courage, honesty, humility, and truth. And I thank you, Creator, for hearing this blessing for all who are here. Bless them with good life, strength, and most of all, the love for one another, for family, community, and friends. Chimigwej Gishiminado Onji Ninuin Emiawin. Thank you, my brothers and sisters, family and friends, relatives, for giving me this time to acknowledge each and every one of you, to acknowledge the ancestors, to bring you greetings on behalf of the Algonquin people, to celebrate with you. And what I say to you as well, just remember, we are in difficult times with this COVID pandemic, but it's nice to see we come together. Take good care of yourselves. Celebrate. Enjoy. Keep learning. For knowledge is power, and our children depend on us to ensure that we continue to provide room and that safe space for knowledge to be shared, because they truly inherit the earth. Chimi Gwej Nishkiwe Dug, Ayang Guamazin Niga Wabmin. Until we see each other again, take good care. Thank you. Migwej.
Migwej, for these profound and so much important words, Elder Claudette Kamanda. Alors, ça commence bien, les célébrations. Je voudrais maintenant accueillir quelqu'un de très important chez Mi'tak's sur scène, John Hepburn. As most of you know, John has served as CEO of MiTax since February 2020. Prior to his appointment, he was Vice President of Research Partnerships at the Canadian Institute for Advanced Research. And before that, he was Vice President of Research at the University of British Columbia. While John is nicely settled into his role as CEO of MiTax, this is his first time participating in person at the MiTax Awards ceremony. Please welcome him. Applaudissons-le chaleureusement.
Merci, Véronique. I don't think I deserve the introduction. Elder Commanda, it was a great pleasure. It's always an honor to have you with us, and thank you for your inspirational words. Thank you very much. I'd like to start by recognizing our partners. They're essential for delivering the outstanding programs we are so very proud of and that we showcase here tonight. We are lucky to have the support of the Government of Canada, and I'll stress this, every single provincial government and the Government of Yukon Territory, and our network of industry, academic, and international partners. Many, many people support MiTax. We need all of their support. Eh bien, je tiens à remercier le ministre Champagne, un grand ami de MiTax, qui est avec nous ce soir, ainsi que l'astronaute canadien David Saint-Jacques. Bienvenue ici. Nous sommes ravis que vous ayez pu vous joindre à nous. Thank you also to the incredible team at MiTax. You are all very important in the delivery of our programs and ultimately in driving Canadian innovation through research and development. And trust me, the MiTax team is not only spectacularly talented, they are spectacularly hardworking on behalf of Canadians. I'd also like to thank our event sponsors, Ciena, VMware, SME Magazine, and The Hill Times for making tonight possible and for all you do to support innovation in Canada. I think we can all agree that the last year and 8 months, seems longer than that, have been unlike anything any of us have lived before. Nevertheless, we at MiTax are justifiably pretty proud of how we've responded to the challenges, and our partners also, the challenges of COVID-19. Last year, we created more than 17,000 innovation internship positions for young people right across this country. Et ce n'est pas tout. Nous avons élargi notre offre en créant le programme Stage de stratégie d'entreprise et nous avons puissé dans davantage de talents grâce à notre initiative autochtone et nos remises pour le PME, le PME, et tout en nous adaptant au télétravail et à l'impossibilité de rencontrer nos partenaires en personne. Grâce au rénovant des investissements, et je veux dire des investissements généreux, du gouvernement fédéral au profit de MiTax dans son budget de l'année dernière et au soutien continu de nos partenaires au niveau provincial et territorial, nous poursuivons sur cet élan. Truly, one of the best parts of my job is hearing about the brilliant innovations that MiTax partnerships are powering from coast to coast and the young researchers we are supporting. Tonight, we have the opportunity to celebrate some of the best and brightest MiTax interns and academic and industry partners whose work is changing Canada's innovation landscape. And we had hundreds of nominations. There were many, many worthy award recipients. We had a very hard time selecting the incredibly talented people you're going to see tonight. Collaborative innovation is a proven and productive approach to research that ultimately helps to deploy top talent within the Canadian economy. Whether our researchers develop groundbreaking ideas by tapping into resources across our country or through international collaboration, their breakthrough work is benefiting all Canadians, and it's this talent that is shaping the future of innovation. Merci encore d'être là ce soir, en personne ou en ligne. nous vous réservons une belle soirée. J'ai maintenant le plaisir de vous présenter une grande amie de Meetax, Carol Saab, pour remettre le prix Meetax pour innovation exceptionnelle postdoctorat. Carol est chef de la direction de la Fédération canadienne des municipalités. An accomplished strategist, having problems even in English, with a decade of experience in federal and municipal advocacy, Carol has been a driving force behind major achievements for Canadian municipalities, including unprecedented government investment. The Federation of Canadian Municipalities is the national voice for Canada's local governments and represents over 2,000 member municipalities from across the country. Her leadership has helped make the FCM one of Canada's most respected and effective advocacy organizations. Je vous invite à vous joindre à moi pour l'accueil.
Thank you very much, John. I'm so pleased to be part of the award ceremony this evening. So thank you to you, to Joe, and the MITACS team for the invitation. Research is integral to decision-making and good public policy. At FCM, we value the research community and our engagement with MITACS, and in particular, the new and now permanent eligibility for municipalities to apply for MITACS funding. And so I'm so pleased to be with you tonight in that spirit, and on behalf of FCM, look forward to growing our partnership in the years to come. And I have the distinct honor tonight of introducing the first award, which is the MITACS Award for Outstanding Innovation Postdoctoral, which is presented to a fellow who has made a significant achievement in research and development during their MITACS-funded fellowship. I'm delighted to announce that this year's winner is Diz Glitherow. Diz is a postdoctoral researcher in the biology department at Dalhousie University. Diz is receiving this award in recognition of her leadership role in developing the world's first ever national ocean literacy strategy, positioning Canada as a global leader in the effort to promote and sustain ocean health. The strategy based on a landmark study involving more than 3,000 Canadians and 400 plus organizations is viewed as a model for all countries to follow. Please join me in congratulating Diz.
Merci beaucoup, Carol, Véronique, Miigwech, Claudette, and good evening, a warm welcome to all of you. It's a tremendous honor to be this year's recipient of the MITACS Award for Postdoctoral. But this award, although humbled, belongs to an entire pan-Canadian MITACS-supported project team. There was 4 postdocs, 3 graduate students, 6 professors, 4 universities, 6 industry partners, and over a dozen additional industry, corporate, NGO partners. So it really was a coast-to-coast-to-coast effort. I am just here as one tonight. Our team often joked that our spirit animal was an octopus. Octopi have neurons in their 8 arms that can sense and gather information from their environment and independently initiate action. And this award and this project affirms just how essential that type of collaboration is. Diverse regions, sectors, knowledge systems, and organizations all working to move forward together. It's a heartfelt thanks to all team members, to MITACS, to all of our sponsors, and to Dr. Boris Worm at Dalhousie University and Janet Stalker, formerly with the Ocean Frontier Institute, for the nomination this evening. Over the past 2.5 years, our team worked with hundreds of organizations, thousands of Canadians, to co-examine our relationship with the ocean and to co-develop a bottom-up, evidence-based national ocean literacy strategy. On March 16th, 2021, we launched Land, Water, Ocean, Us, a Canadian ocean literacy strategy, and as Carol noted, the first one in the world. What is ocean literacy, And why a national strategy? Take a moment. Take a breath. On your inhale, thank the ocean. Over 50% of the oxygen we breathe comes from the ocean. It regulates our climate. It provides feeds billions of people and provides jobs for millions, and so much more. But for over 30 million Canadians who live nowhere near the ocean, it's hard to have that daily reminder as to why it matters, why our relationship and our dependence with the ocean matters. 2021 marks the first year of the Ocean Decade declared by the United Nations. It's an opportunity for us all to come together, and it's an opportunity for ocean literacy to be used as a mechanism for change, for us all to evaluate our relationship with the ocean, and to empower all of us, not just government and policymakers, but all of us, to become engaged civic actors to ensure ocean health for future generations. There is only one global ocean, and as Canadians, we have an important role to play as ocean stewards, leaders, and innovators. Merci beaucoup encore to MITAX and to the entire project team. Thank you.
Wonderful prize. J'aimerais maintenant accueillir quelqu'un que vous connaissez certainement tous, l'honorable François-Philippe Champagne. Alors, élu pour la première fois député de Saint-Maurice-Champlain en 2015, après une carrière réussie en droit et dans les affaires, le ministre Champagne a exercé la fonction de secrétaire parlementaire du ministre des Finances, de ministre du Commerce international et de ministre des Affaires étrangères. Most recently, we've gotten to know him in his capacity as Minister of Innovation, Science and Industry, a position which he was reappointed to recently. Please join me in a warm welcoming Mr. l'honorable François-Philippe Champagne.
Bonsoir tout le monde. Good evening, everyone. It's a real pleasure. Thank you for those who are joining us at home. I think there's a number of people which are joining us at home tonight. Merci, Véronique, d'abord pour vos mots d'introduction qui sont toujours aussi gentils. C'est un plaisir d'être avec vous ce soir. And I just want to make us realize that tonight and to welcome all of you because you are participating to Canada's top research innovation event in the country. So that's something, and I want to say, and the elder was with us, which is always inspiring us when we start our journey and when we have events. I just want to say, if knowledge is power, I would say that role models are powerful. And I know that later on tonight, David Saint-Jacques will be talking, my good friend David, and je voulais vous remercier au nom de tous les participants ce soir d'être avec nous ce soir parce que s'il y a quelqu'un qui inspire la génération à venir de gens qui veulent se dépasser, qui veulent voir loin, vous êtes même allé jusque dans l'espace, je dois vous dire merci de prendre le temps d'être avec nous ce soir puis je vais vous donner une main d'applaudissement d'avoir... Vous avez franchi les plus grandes limites, vous inspirez plusieurs Canadiens et Canadiennes, alors ce sera un plaisir de vous entendre un peu plus tard ce soir. Je veux aussi remercier MITAC d'être avec, d'organiser cet événement-là ce soir, et John Hepburn. John, I just want to applaud your leadership and to thank you for inviting me to this great event tonight. There's no place I would rather be tonight after a throne speech today to inspire a new generation and recognize people like Liz. I can see you, but I heard you. Amazing people like you are putting Canada as a leader in the world, and John, the great work you do. It's easy, you know, for the government of Canada and myself to be a partner because you are excellence. You bring excellence to everything you do. So it's very easy. I'm the ambassador of excellence when I think about MITAX and the work that the people and your team that you're doing. Alors, ce soir, à l'occasion de la 11e remise annuelle des prix MITAX, nous soulignons bien évidemment ensemble l'importance des progrès réalisés grâce à la multitude des talents qui nous entourent. Depuis leur création, les prix MITAX, qui sont un moment important, je dirais, au niveau des hommages qui sont rendus dans l'année à nos innovateurs et certainement les gens les plus brillants à travers le pays. Et pour que le Canada puisse maintenir notre position de leadership et l'avantage concurrentiel qui vient avec les innovateurs, avec le talent, avec l'excellence, bien, nous devons donner aux jeunes innovateurs les outils dont ils ont besoin pour réussir. So that's why we launched, as you will recall, and you were very nice to acknowledge what we did on the skills plan, but our innovation and skills plan. If I think about the government of Canada, if I think about, and as you, Helder, always remind us, the seventh generation, and how do you look, and I always try to think, what can we do today for 30 to 50 years ahead? You know, how do we plan for the future? And when I think about innovation and skills, there's really nothing more important than that, to give opportunities, to give the training. And I'm always reminded that the investments we make today will pay dividend for generations to come. That's why, to meet the need of growing industries, you probably saw that we announced $250 million to make sure that we scale up our industry-led approaches in training and that we could redeploy thousands of workers. And as some of you know, I spent a good part of my professional career before politics in Europe. And the model of MITAX just reminds me of the best that you see in Switzerland and Germany, and that we have embraced that as Canadians makes me very proud, and that we have found a great partner in MITAX. So, in fact, if you look at the business and the higher education roundtable, that is continuing to strengthen, I would say, the work-integrated learning process. And if you look around the world as the most innovative nation in the world, they've done that right. And I think with MITAX, that's exactly what we're getting at, is to do it right to make sure that we can have work and knowledge at the same time, that you learn through being integrated in a learning ecosystem, but a working ecosystem. And the way you're doing it, I must say, in MITAX, you're building partnerships that promote experiential learning, which will lead to transformational achievements. And I think that's what we see tonight. And I had the privilege, like some of you, to read about those who are going to get the awards tonight. It's truly impressive. Je le répète sans cesse, notre meilleur atout pour saisir les opportunités à venir, ce sont bien évidemment le talent de nos étudiants et de nos travailleurs. Et je le répète encore plus souvent, car c'est les talents qui attirent les investissements. Et ça, il faut se rappeler. I always say it's talent bring investment. It's easy for me, somewhat. I have my deputy minister would say somewhat easy. But it's kind of easy for us to attract investments in Canada because we have the talent. If you look at people who want to come to our shore, the first thing they ask minister is, do we have enough talent? And that's what I like about MITAX and what you're doing, because you're bringing these talents to the forefront, and that will allow us to attract investment. And that's why MITAX is so important, because you build these strategic partnerships between industry, government and academia. Et les stages offerts par MITAX permettent évidemment de former des étudiants hautement qualifiés à travers le pays. Et ce serait pas possible de faire tout ça sans toute l'équipe de MITAX. So, if you would indulge with me, I'd like to give a big round of applause to the whole team of MITAX for putting the event tonight, but for the work that they are doing day in, day out to make sure that talent, that we would find the talent, that we would honor them and give them the tools. That's really what MITAX is all about. So you make us very, very proud. Alors, ce soir, je suis très heureux, comme vous pouvez le voir, de remettre un prix à l'une de ces personnes les plus talentueuses, le prix MITAX pour innovation exceptionnelle, ce qu'on appelle Maîtrise 2000-2001, est décerné à un étudiant qui a fait de son projet financé par MITAX un réel succès. Le lauréat de cette année, and I'm sure you like to do it in both languages, so I'll make you wait a bit more. So the recipient of this year's award, which is someone which is very accomplished and inspiring for a lot of Canadians, Adam Shatner, qui est de la Polytechnique à Montréal et dont les travaux de recherche ont été supervisés par le professeur Philippe Doyon-Poulin. So bear with me. So what Adam has been doing, and that will make, maybe you can refer to that, David, when you're going to be talking. So what he did, using helicopter vibration data from the National Research Council, what Adam has been doing is how these vibrations affect the touchscreens being installed in aircraft. Think about that. He created the first of its kind vibration simulator that now allows to quantify the effect of vibrations and learn how to mitigate them. I must say I'm very proud, Adam, that you're on the case because I fly very often, and I'm sure there's many of us in the room that now that you made us aware of the vibration in the screen, and David, you went to space, so I want to hear from you about that. Adam, we're all behind you. We support you and want to make sure that you bring the best to the aviation industry. And in fact, il y a déjà deux entreprises québécoises d'aérospatiale qui ont déjà demandé à Polytechnique de pouvoir utiliser les essais qui ont été réalisés par Adam. Et même CMC Electronics l'a même embauché à temps plein, ce qui va lui permettre d'appliquer les découvertes et lui permettre évidemment de continuer avec son projet. Alors, bravo Adam pour ses réalisations. In conclusion, I just want to say to all of you and to all the recipients, I want to end with two things. I would like to say, let's seize the moment. I don't think there's never been a better time to invest in innovation and science and technology and invest in you. Be ambitious and let's together to promote the next generation of ambitious and talented innovators in our country. Merci tout le monde d'être ici ce soir. Adam, join me on the podium because you're getting the big award tonight. Merci.
Monsieur Champagne, et merci Mitax, CMC Électronique, le CRSNG, Polytechnique Montréal, le laboratoire Lesiac et toutes les personnes qui m'ont aidé. Et merci infiniment à mon directeur de recherche formidable, professeur Philippe Doyon-Poulin. Imagine flying a helicopter in rough weather, jostled as you reach towards a distant touchscreen. As aircraft become more automated, piloting is becoming more like using any other computerized device, and avionic touchscreens are seeing increasing use. We need to design for their limitations and use them appropriately. Des écrans tactiles sont en train d'être installés dans des vieux avions durant des rénovations. Ces écrans sont fréquemment installés loin du pilote, et le niveau de vibration dans un hélicoptère est souvent très élevé. Our study provides quantitative values for how helicopter vibration impacts touchscreen use. We tested different target sizes to determine which provide acceptable touch accuracy and tested a vibration mitigation strategy. We built a representative vibration test platform and used real helicopter vibration data to drive it, provided by the NRC. This platform can now be used for future academic and industrial tests. Montréal est un centre mondial de l'aéronautique. Deux compagnies aéronautiques québécoises nous ont déjà contactés pour exprimer leur intérêt d'utiliser notre plateforme de vibration. My research is having an immediate impact. Through the MITAX Accelerate Fellowship, I've been collaborating with CMC Electronics, a Canadian avionics company, and CMC now hired me full-time, allowing me to directly apply my research findings in the design of real aircraft systems. Cette étroite collaboration entre le milieu universitaire et l'industrie était seulement possible avec le support de MITAX. Merci, thank you.
Well, congratulations, Adam, and thank you so much, Honorable François-Philippe Champagne. J'aimerais maintenant attirer votre attention sur les écrans derrière moi, de chaque côté de moi, pour regarder et écouter un message d'un grand ami de MITAX. Il s'agit du ministre québécois, du ministre de l'Économie et de l'Innovation, M. Pierre Fitzgibbon.
Bonsoir tout le monde. Je suis très heureux de m'adresser à vous encore cette année, dans le cadre de cette soirée des prix MITAX 2021. Vous pouvez être sûr que les événements qui célèbrent l'innovation me tiennent à cœur. L'innovation, c'est la bougie d'allumage de notre développement, de notre croissance économique. Si on veut augmenter notre richesse collective et notre niveau de vie, notre économie doit être plus productive. Ça passe assurément par l'innovation ainsi que l'implantation de nouvelles technologies et de nouvelles façons de faire. C'est en encourageant les liens entre la recherche et l'industrie qu'on favorise l'essor de nouvelles solutions concrètes. Notre capacité à innover vient aussi de la rencontre entre nos institutions d'enseignement supérieur et notre main-d'œuvre spécialisée. Les prix MITAX mettent en vedette des exemples exceptionnels de collaboration entre l'industrie et le milieu post-secondaire. MITAX est d'ailleurs un partenaire de longue date. Au fil des ans, MITAX a appuyé des centaines d'entreprises, d'étudiantes et d'étudiants de partout au Québec. Ensemble, nous travaillons à soutenir les secteurs économiques les plus prometteurs, comme les sciences numériques, l'aérospatiale, les sciences de la vie et les énergies propres. Ces projets sont venus stimuler davantage la croissance et la productivité de nos entreprises. Certains ont même joué un rôle important dans la lutte contre la COVID-19. Avant de conclure, j'aimerais féliciter les 8 gagnants de la soirée. Ils et elles sont des modèles pour leurs pairs et pour nous tous. Cette année encore, vos succès sont célébrés de façon virtuelle, mais on sait tous qu'ils sont bel et bien réels et qu'ils contribuent à faire progresser la société. Félicitations pour vos efforts et pour vos réalisations. Merci.
And I would like to invite again on stage Elder Claudette Commanda to present the award of Outstanding Innovation Indigenous.
Earlier when I said to you, there's no goodbye, and until we see each other again, I said, Yangwamazin, Nigawamin. So here we are, we're seeing one another again. But I'm very pleased and very honored to present this year's MITAX Award for Outstanding Innovation Indigenous. Created in 2019, this prize recognizes outstanding work by an Indigenous researcher. This year's winner, Monica Sinclair, is a postdoctoral health researcher in the Environment and Geography Department at the University of Manitoba. She earned a distinction for her work to roll out a first-of-its-kind mobile app that empowers Indigenous communities to own their own data. The research tool is currently being used in Manitoba, British Columbia, and as far away as Ecuador, where communities are surveying their populations on important health and social issues, including COVID-19, housing, language, and youth suicides. Congratulations, Monica. I am sure many, many, many look forward to seeing your innovation create change for Indigenous peoples around the world. Chi miigwech.
Thank you, Veronique. Kananaskumitten Elder Commander. I'm Dr. Monica Sinclair, postdoctoral student at the University of Manitoba. Winning this award enables me to continue to work with Indigenous communities and people in collaborative research, where Indigenous peoples have taken the lead in developing research that will continue long after COVID-19 is over. I sincerely want to thank Dr. Stephen McLaughlin, Dr. Ramona Nekwe, and Dr. Merle Ballard. The last two people I mentioned are both Indigenous. I also want to thank Kimberly Wild, who tirelessly explained the project to me because I joined the project in its second year of inception. So it's, you know, a newbie trying to figure out what the heck's going on. So the overall goal of this project was to support Indigenous communities as they respond to COVID-19 with the development of a digital app called Our Data Indigenous that can be used by communities to conduct their own COVID-19 research, thereby generating data that can be used to help to inform local decision making. The benefits of the app is that the data generated utilizes the OCAP principles, which means data owned by, controlled by, accessible to, and possessed by the communities that use the app. And the research by the university focuses on the nature of this Indigenous-led approach to participatory technology design. Possibly this design can be used in the future with other industries. Currently, the app is now being, as Elder Commanda said, it's being used across Manitoba, in BC, and Puerto Rico, and soon in Ecuador. This project has enabled me to learn about how digital apps can create data that will be useful for communities. Training in communities must be done with plain language and many practice sessions, especially if in-person training is not possible with COVID-19 lockdowns. We've done so many trainings with communities, and we've tried to make it very simple and basic for them to understand. So that was one thing that when you're in academia, people tend to talk in that academic language, and then trying to get them to speak to communities in language that they understand was a big hurdle. So, and also the infographics we made them so they were easy to understand and easy for people to use. In addition, at the back of developing the app, we found out a whole bunch of things were happening in community. One, there isn't a lot of connectivity, and there's a lot of power outages. So we created connectivity pack, so people could actually have that pack in their communities, and then when we leave, they can keep that pack, and they can also keep the app, and they have a small generator. So there's different things in place, so when it does have power outages, there's ways that they could continue to use that app. So for me, this app has opened the door to many possibilities with future research projects for communities. Thank you, Egosani.
Such important research. Congratulations again, Monica. Hopefully it will be spread across Canada in other regions. Our next speaker is another longtime friend of MyTacs, a renowned doctor, medical researcher, academic. Dr. Michael Strong currently serves as president of the Canadian Institutes of Health Research. Dr. Strong has published over 200 peer-reviewed articles, 29 chapters, edited 4 books, and given over 175 lectures on ALS, his area of expertise, in Canada and around the world. He is the recipient of both the Sheila Essay Award and the Forbes Norris Award, the only Canadian to have received both. He was also awarded the Queen Elizabeth II Diamond Jubilee Medal in 2012 for his contributions to ALS research, and he is a fellow of the Canadian Academy of Health Research, Health Sciences. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Maurice Strong.
Merci and bonjour tout le monde. To the minister, welcome to John and your team. What a wonderful evening. What impressive stories. It's a real pleasure to be part and parcel of this. Thank you for the invitation. So now I have the distinct pleasure of announcing the winner of this year's MyTacs Award for Outstanding Innovation in Industry. The industry prize is awarded to a partner who demonstrates exceptional collaboration between the private sector and academia, providing valuable training experience and generating research with significant outcomes. This year's winner is the Structural Genomics Consortium, a Canadian-led group of pharmaceutical companies, clinicians, and academics who are receiving the award for the discovery or for their transformative open science approach to new drug discovery. I'm going to insert in there, I learned this evening that it's over 400 people that are involved in this at one level or another. This is absolutely amazing. By removing intellectual property restrictions and freely sharing the building blocks required to carry out experiments on the proteins that make up the human genome, SGC is creating a paradigm shift in the pharma industry, making it feasible to pursue affordable treatments for rare diseases such as childhood cancers and to respond rapidly to emerging viral infections like COVID-19. Please welcome to the stage Arij Al-Shawaf, who is accepting the award on behalf of the SGC.
Merci, Mike. I'm Arij Al-Shawaf, Executive Director for Strategic Initiative Development at the University of Toronto. And formerly, I held the position of Director of Strategic Alliances and Communications at the Structural Genomics Consortium. On behalf of the Structural Genomics Consortium, or SGC as it's known, I'd like to thank the MITAX Review Committee for this wonderful honor. While at the SGC, I had the pleasure of partnering with MITAX on the Accelerate Cluster Genes to Affordable Medicines to offer internships for over 60 postdoctoral fellows, one of many SGC projects that we grew into valuable training opportunities with support from MITAX. A bit about the organization receiving this honor. SGC is a global public-private partnership dedicated to accelerating drug discovery using open science. With research hubs in 5 countries, the SGC has been reimagining a collaboration model in which ideas are shared freely across partners and sectors unencumbered by intellectual property ownership. This open science ecosystem provided a unique training environment, offering a seamless transition for trainees between industry, not-for-profit, and academia in cutting-edge multidisciplinary research areas. SGC's MITAX trainees have made important contributions to science, from developing cancer models to testing antivirals against COVID-19, all within SGC's open science ecosystem. Recently, MITAX provided the opportunity for a remarkable postdoctoral fellow from McGill University to work seamlessly between McGill, SGC, and another company to create a research reagent that binds Parkin, a protein implicated in Parkinson's disease. Until now, this reagent had been unsuccessfully sought after for 20 years. Again, I would like to thank MITAX. I would like to give a special thanks to all of SGC's MITAX trainees, SGC's academic and industry partners, and the numerous research collaborators around the world. It's these relationships built on trust, cooperation, and a passion for innovation that makes open science possible. Merci.
Congratulations to you, Arish, and to the Structural Genomics Consortium. I would now like to introduce a relatively new player in the world of scientific innovation, Monsieur Luc Sirois, qui a été nommé innovateur en chef du Québec en décembre dernier. Veuillez chaleureusement accueillir Monsieur Luc Sirois.
Bonsoir Véronique, bonsoir tout le monde. Et hey, c'est le fun, ça me donne des sentiments de jeunesse de me faire introduire comme un nouveau joueur. Vous savez, c'est un privilège de cette fête demandée par le gouvernement du Québec de jouer ce rôle d'innovateur en chef, un rôle nouveau, mais c'est un rôle extrêmement spécial parce que c'est le rôle que vous tous, vous jouez dans votre quotidien. On a un ministre avec nous qui est un fabuleux innovateur en chef pour tout le Canada, qui, vous l'avez entendu, un grand motivateur. On l'applaudit d'ailleurs, hein? C'est extraordinaire de l'entendre à nous. Et on a des gens chez MITAX ici qui sont des promoteurs de l'innovation, qui font arriver les connexions, qui font travailler les gens de la science et de l'industrie ensemble. Au Québec, c'est un privilège de travailler avec le scientifique en chef. It's a real privilege to work with a chief scientist, Rémi Quirion. But it's also a real privilege to work with the MITAX people. Because you know what? One day, there should be a MITAX award for MITAX. They are truly innovative. They are agile. They invent new ways to connect industry, new ways to bring the youth to the world, to make them have an impact in society. That is called social innovation. You've seen them on the ground. You've seen them in universities. Vous les avez vus partout à l'œuvre. Ils inventent toujours des nouvelles façons de connecter, mais des nouvelles façons d'amener la jeunesse à se développer, à avoir un impact. Et comme personne aussi qui nous pousse à avoir un impact, à se dépasser. Pour moi, c'est un grand privilège de vous présenter notre invité d'honneur ce soir. C'est une personne qui nous fait rêver, qui nous rappelle nous-mêmes ces étincelles que l'on a eues quand on était jeune, d'un jour imaginer peut-être être des scientifiques, des innovateurs, innovatrices. mais c'est une personne qui donne l'étincelle dans l'esprit de nos jeunes aujourd'hui. C'est l'idole de mes enfants, c'est l'idole d'une génération. Mais pas parce qu'il est astronaute, pas parce qu'il est allé dans l'espace. Ça, en soi, c'est des exploits extraordinaires. Mais parce qu'il donne la permission de rêver, il donne aux jeunes, il donne à la génération, il donne aux Canadiens l'espoir qu'on peut se dépasser, qu'on peut bâtir ici une expertise extraordinaire de science, de médecine, d'ingénierie, de mathématiques, de technologie, et qu'on peut rayonner partout dans le monde. Il nous donne cet espoir, il nous donne ce rêve, et c'est pour ça, mesdames et messieurs, que je vous invite à applaudir très chaleureusement le commander David Saint-Jacques, mesdames et messieurs.
Merci de me recevoir à cette fête de l'innovation. Je suis un peu comme la récréation, là. Je suis la pause dans la série de prix. Je vais essayer de vous faire rêver un peu, peut-être, vous donner la permission de rêver. Et en même temps, on peut parler de l'espace, de l'innovation et de tous les liens que ça a entre nous. Où est-ce qu'on est rendu dans les slides? David Saint-Jacques. Donc, avant d'être astronaute, j'étais médecin dans le Grand Nord du Québec. Mais en fait, c'est pas comme ça que j'ai commencé, c'est comme ça que j'ai commencé, comme tout le monde. Les rêves dans la tête des enfants, c'est un peu notre plus grande ressource. Et notre jeunesse, c'est ça notre avenir. Hein? Et le mieux qu'on peut se faire comme adulte, dans le fond, c'est de passer le bâton et de s'assurer que that there's a future to the world, and that goes through our youth. So these images that you briefly saw, that you can imagine, really made me dream big as I was a kid. And they completely blew away my perspective of what can be. Et j'ai comme décidé, pas de devenir un astronaute, mais de devenir un explorateur. Et surtout, j'avais un rêve complètement fou de tout comprendre. Impossible, mais I'm going to try. The points I want to make tonight is that the dream to understand the world around us is really at the core of innovation. And I know il y a beaucoup de gens pour qui la science, la recherche, c'est un peu aride. Vous ici, vous êtes des gens qui comprenez l'intérêt de ça. La réalité, c'est que c'est juste des rêves. C'est juste le rêve de vouloir comprendre le monde autour de nous, de faire du sens. Et c'est de ce rêve-là qui peut s'exprimer par les arts, ou par les sciences, ou par l'exploration, que progresse la civilisation. Fait que, ici, ce que j'adore de ce que vous faites, MITAX, c'est que vous permettez aux jeunes de contribuer, vous leur donnez le droit de rêver à un monde meilleur. Et ça peut prendre plein de formes, ça. Pour les gens qui ont un peu un esprit d'ingénieur, bien, ça prend la forme de l'innovation technologique. On en a tous grand besoin. Il y a des rêves qu'on a tous dans le programme spatial. Je vais profiter pour en parler brièvement. Hein, on a tous vu ces images des gens qui sont allés sur la Lune. On va y retourner. Le Canada fait partie du Concert des Nations qui veut retourner sur la Lune. On va contribuer à la robotique. Canadarm3, an artificial intelligence-enabled robot, is going to be like our little, somewhere between C-3PO and R2-D2 to take care of the lunar gateway on behalf of the astronauts when they're not there. But the Moon is about 1,000 times further away from the Earth than the space station. And so we've been there, but to live there is a different level of challenge. What I want to tell you about, if you want to dream, is Mars. That's really what we have our mindset on. Mars, c'est 1,000 fois plus loin que la Lune. Le défi est monstrueux. Mars, dans le ciel, vous l'avez vu, là, c'est un petit point rouge. So when you're on Mars, that's what the Earth looks like. Like a little blue dot. To go to Mars, we'll need to master so many things. We'll need to master, basically, at high level environment, resource management, recycling of water and air, food production. Hey, that's going to help us on Earth, eh? We're going to need to master energy production and management. Hey, that's also going to help us with the crisis we have. We'll need to fix some of our international relations so we can work together to get there. That's great. We'll need to get major strides in medicine. so that the crews can have a chance of surviving that mission to Mars et revenir sur Terre à leur famille. Et ça, on n'est pas encore rendu là, mais c'est tous des problèmes cruciaux pour l'humanité, sur notre vie sur Terre. Et c'est comme si l'espace était l'excuse dont on a besoin pour se creuser la tête un petit peu plus. Ça a tellement une capacité d'exciter le génie humain that makes us want to solve problems we might not have considered solvable before. And then we do it, and here we are. This is the Apollo Navigation and Guidance Computer. It looks like nothing to us right now, but when they developed that, à cette époque-là, les ordinateurs, c'était gros comme un édifice. And it worked well, and there was no need to make computers any smaller. Yeah, but then NASA thought, well, you know, to go to the moon, it would need to be a little bit smaller than a building, maybe like this. This is the ancestor of all the technology that we kind of depend on now in computer science. So l'excuse de l'exploration spatiale, les difficultés extrêmes de cet environnement-là, historiquement, font toujours ça. Ça fournit l'excuse un peu pour qu'on se rende plus loin. Et après ça, on en bénéficie tous. Puis pour les jeunes dans la salle, c'est pas un secret, je vais vous dire ça. Je vais faire réaliser que les astronautes qui vont aller sur Mars, les scientifiques qui vont mettre au point les processus requis pour survivre, les ingénieurs qui vont fabriquer ces systèmes-là, ils sont déjà nés. Mais c'est des jeunes, encore. C'est des gens en formation. C'est des rêves dans la tête de jeunes êtres humains. Avec MITAX et d'autres organisations, c'est ça notre rôle, aux vieux comme moi, de passer le bâton et de vous permettre d'y rêver. C'est des beaux rêves à avoir. Notre avenir est entre vos mains. Merci aux jeunes. Merci à MITAX. Thank you, everybody.
Continuez à écouter le commandant Saint-Jacques. Merci infiniment pour ces paroles tellement inspirantes. J'aimerais maintenant vous inviter encore une fois à regarder l'écran qui est là maintenant pour entendre le ministre de l'Ontario, Jill Dunlop, le ministre des Collèges et des Universités.
Good evening, I'm Jill Dunlop, Minister of Colleges and Universities. Congratulations to all the winners of this year's MITAX Awards. You represent world-class talent from post-secondary institutions in Ontario and across Canada. And our government knows that real-world experience is key to help students develop the skills they need to get in-demand jobs after graduation. That is why we are proud to partner with MITAX, an organization that fosters growth and innovation in Canada by solving business challenges with research solutions from academic institutions. Through government funding, MITAX has created thousands of research internships for post-secondary students from law, technology, and business to the environment and healthcare sectors. Ontario's support is helping MITAX build partnerships between education and industry. Partnerships that facilitate high-quality experiential learning opportunities to tackle today's biggest research challenges. During COVID-19, this has included collaborations with small businesses and projects that address pandemic-related issues. Ontario's economy and future prosperity rely on having a nimble and highly skilled workforce that is ready to take on the challenges we face today and those we can't even anticipate down the road. Students and researchers at our province's post-secondary institutions conduct high-quality research that contributes to Ontario's innovation-based economy. Collaboration between businesses, students, and researchers offers huge potential for sustainable, competitive, and long-term economic growth in Ontario. By supporting hands-on, innovative internships, we are providing graduates with the experience they need to get good jobs and preparing the next generation of talent to support Ontario businesses. A win-win for everybody. This evening's awards celebrate the remarkable achievements of students and faculty who have participated in MITAX programs. Your hard work is making a real impact on Ontario, and for that, you should be very proud. Congratulations again, and I wish you the best in the road ahead.
And now please welcome Mr. Rodney Wilson of Siena, who will introduce us to the award for professor, the best leader in professorship in Canada. Welcome.
If research is a curiosity-driven business, it's the professors that spark the curiosity. So I'm very pleased to present this year's MITAX Award for Exceptional Leadership Professor. The MITAX Award for Exceptional Leadership Professor is presented to an academic supervisor with an exemplary record of developing collaborations, providing valuable research and training experiences to interns, and initiating research projects with significant outcomes through MITAX funding. This year's winner is Dr. Ray Spitari. Dr. Spitari is a computer science professor at the University of Saskatchewan. He is receiving tonight's award in recognition of his outstanding effort to facilitate more than 16 research collaborations with industry. Most recently, the development of a game-changing virtual shopping avatar that accurately mirrors how different body types and uses heat maps to develop online shoppers the ability to visualize how clothes will fit. I would like to present Professor Spitari with a rather unique challenge in myself. However, please join me in congratulating the professor, and I can't wait to try it on for size.
Thanks, Rod, and challenge accepted. Merci, Véronique. It is a true honor for me to be part of the celebration, an honor to be with you all here today. Colleagues, esteemed award winners, an honor to receive this award. I would like to begin by giving my heartfelt thanks to those on my team and those from industry and MITAX who have made this possible. I am grateful to all of you for your contributions. I would not be here without you. 20 years. That is how long I have had the privilege of being associated with MITAX. I was a MITAX project leader in the early 2000s and a regional scientific director until 2012. And while on sabbatical, I've just finished participating in the MITAX Industry Faculty Collaboration for Innovation with Siemens Electronics Design and Automation. So in other words, I've been a MITAX intern myself for the past 3 months. I've always said it's really good to be able to walk the walk. So for anyone stubborn enough to stick with doing something for a long time, you know what a fantastic feeling it is when your community recognizes your work. We hear a lot about mathematical modeling these days. Coronavirus, climate change, floods. As you can imagine, these models need to be run on supercomputers in order to obtain answers in a timely fashion, if at all. My research focuses on helping people get their models to work. I do this by developing new and better algorithms and software for the solution of differential equations, which are the building blocks of many of such models. So yeah, this is my version of living the dream. MITAX internships are a win-win proposition. The first two winners are the universities and Canada. But the biggest winners, of course, are the interns who get to apply their knowledge to real world problems, and the industry and our industrial partners who, of course, get a fresh perspective on their problems, plus an up-close look at new talent. And the last group of winners, of course, are the professors. Because of MITAX internships, we get to work on problems that we may otherwise never hear of. So in closing, thank you again, MITAX. Thank you for this award and the rocket fuel it is giving me to keep going for the next 20 years.
Félicitations encore une fois, Professor Spitari, for this inspirational speech and congratulations on your exceptional leadership. Our next speaker will introduce the International Award winner. Monsieur Marc Fortin is the Vice President of Research Partnerships at the Natural Sciences Engineering Research Council of Canada, better known as NSERC. Please welcome Mr. Fortin.
Bonsoir, bonsoir, good evening everyone. Bonsoir, Monsieur le Ministre. Merci, merci Monsieur le Ministre d'être un grand champion de la science, de l'innovation, de la recherche pour le Canada. Et on célèbre ce soir de jeunes et de moins jeunes innovateurs, inventeurs qui vont être ce qui va propulser l'innovation au Canada. Alors, merci de votre rôle. Thank you, John, for inviting me here tonight for this fantastic celebration of talent and of collaboration. Now, you may wonder, what is an NSERC person? NSERC stands for the National Sciences and Engineering Research Council of Canada. What is an NSERC person doing on stage at a MITACS celebration? That's a fair question. But there's a good answer. And the answer is that we both believe deeply that research, science, knowledge is the fuel for innovation in the future. We both collaborate in supporting talent. We both collaborate to support research. And we collaborate because we believe that leveraging each other's organizations, each other's investments, each other's complementary strengths will help propel Canadian innovation, Canadian talent in the future. We at NSERC are about to launch a new component of our programming that will support international collaborations. I won't say more tonight. This is MITACS night. But the reason I'm mentioning this is because we have, over the last few years, collaborated very significantly to simplify the work of researchers, of interns, when applying to programs. We will continue to work together because we are convinced that by working together, we drive innovation and we support talent development. We will continue to work together in the international sphere as we both develop areas of activity there. And I was listening, John, to the strategic plan presentation a bit earlier today, and international was a component, an important component, of the new MITACS strategy that is available on the web now, I think. It's Christmas coming. Maybe we want to give gifts of MITACS strategies to family and friends. So MITACS strategy, MITACS initiatives in international collaboration that have existed for quite some years now. MITACS initiative relies on recognizing the value of two-way exchanges of researchers between Canadian researchers who get an experience, a learning experience abroad, but also foreign students, interns, researchers, brought to Canada and enrich the Canadian innovation ecosystem. And those two-way exchanges are extremely important. I think we all recognize that tonight. The award tonight is for MITACS Award for its Outstanding Innovation in the International category. This award is presented to a researcher that is making a significant contribution through international collaboration. Je vais faire comme le ministre, je vais étendre un petit peu l'annonce en parlant français légèrement. Ça me fait un grand plaisir ce soir, c'est un honneur pour moi d'honorer les contributions de Sophie Charron. Sophie Charron, qui est au niveau de la maîtrise à l'Université de Toronto. So it's an honor tonight to recognize Sophie Charron as the recipient for the international category tonight. Sophie is a master's researcher in medieval studies at the University of Toronto. She's receiving the award tonight for uncovering new historical information about the important political and cultural role of queens in 14th century Central Europe, specifically Bohemia. Now, How many of you have heard of the role of queens in Bohemia in the 14th century? I'll speculate and say that not too many of us. Well, this is precisely why Sophie's work is important. Because Sophie is the first to offer a gender-critical feminist counterpoint view that will close a gender gap and a knowledge gap in the role of women in medieval Bohemia. I find that absolutely fascinating. I hope she will give us a snippet of her work. I like history. I'm not an historian, but I love history. So I really look forward to reading more of her work. So through the MyTax Global Link program, Sophie was able to travel to the Czech Republic, learn some of the language and some of the manuscript skills that she needed to do her research work. Sophie, it's a great honor to recognize you. MyTax is very proud of the work that you're doing. Merci pour ton travail.
Let's not make it more historical by dropping it. So thank you, Marc and Véronique. My name is Sophie Charron, and I'm a master's student at the Centre for Medieval Studies at the University of Toronto. And I'm honoured to receive this award, and would like to thank MyTax for the profound impact their support had on my research. I would also like to thank my supervisor, Shami Ghosh, my host supervisor, David Kolhaus, and my colleagues at Masaryk University in Brno, Czechia, who hosted me during my MyTax Global Link experience. My research focuses on the wives of Charles IV of Bohemia, who was the King of Bohemia and the Holy Roman Emperor in the mid-14th century. Charles had four wives, Blanche of Valois, Anne of Bavaria, Anne of Świnicka, and Elizabeth of Pomerania, but their contributions to politics and culture have been overlooked in the existing scholarship. I want to fill that gap. More broadly, I'm asking, what did it mean to be queen in medieval Bohemia? How did the queen manifest her authority? To what extent was she involved in shaping the culture of the court? Queens faced barriers in exercising power, and they often had unofficial powers that deserve analysis as rigorous as that applied traditionally to male expressions of authority. Because of MyTax's generous funding, I was able to study in Brno for 6 months in 2019 and 2020. I was able to take specialized courses, visit foreign libraries, and see historic sites relevant to my research. My work will enrich our understanding of the Bohemian court and monarchy and shed light on the horizons of agency of late medieval queens. I hope, too, that my work will challenge assumptions about the exercise of power and that the insights and lessons of history will change how we think about gender and inclusivity in politics. Thank you.
Surprise guest tonight. I'd like to introduce to you Benoît Pelletier, the director of Edge and AI Ecosystems with VMware. He will deliver remarks and present to us the PhD award winner.
Merci beaucoup, Véronique. Alors, je suis excessivement heureux et excité, je pense qu'après 2 ans sans voir des vraies personnes, d'être avec vous autres dans la salle et de sentir cette vibration, cette énergie avec des gens inspirants comme le ministre Champagne, aussi avec David, on a eu la chance de dîner ensemble. C'est la deuxième fois que je dîne avec lui. La première fois, c'était dans la station spatiale et c'était virtuel. Il ne savait pas. John, les distingués invités. Alors, je pense que ce qui est important de comprendre aujourd'hui, c'est notre passion. Si on est ici, c'est notre passion pour l'innovation. Et je pense qu'un message qui ressort bien de David, c'est le rêve. Pour moi, la passion de faire l'innovation puis d'aider les jeunes, ce qui est important, c'est de garder ses rêves. Souvent, les gens meurent à 25 ans et on les enterre à 82 parce qu'ils ont arrêté de rêver. So I think that one of the key things that we need to convey here is the strength of MITAX in the way they can connect the industry with the academia. Mr. Champagne said, you know, it's important that we leverage our great Canadian ecosystem of innovation. If we want to be first on the planet, we need to work together. We need to make sure that when we start small, and that's what I've done, I've gone work with Eric and his team over the last decade with MITAX. So I think that David will say it's like le premier pas sur la lune. Le plus dur, c'est l'effort de le faire. But after that, you know, you go and you see the benefits, and then you build. And if we are all together in Canada to build innovation, we'll be able to succeed. And I'm very proud to announce, and listening to Mr. Champagne. So I joined VMware a year ago. And the first thing I thought was about, you know, the great collaboration with MITAX. So bringing from VMware, we're based in Silicon Valley, and I was there last year with Bernard as well from MITAX. And I was saying that Canada is the best place to be. And I was able, and I'm very proud to announce, that we will announce, you know, that VMware will do its Digital Innovation Grid initiative. It's known as TITRA. And it's all about paving the way to sustainable path to 6G. And that's going to be done here in Canada because we have the talent, because we have the great ecosystems. And that's what we need to do. So bring, you know, the effort of doing the research here. We've got great researchers. We've got great industry. And this is what we need, is make sure that we connect them together. So as part of this plan to do this, I'm very proud that we will announce that we will do a TITRA Research and Innovation Center here in Canada. And that's going to be with MITAX. And that's going to be making sure that we're going to be able to succeed on the path to 6G. And we're going to focus on three initial areas for applied research. The first one will be sustainable grid. Make sure that we can create an open grid that provide access to the resources of physical data and digital, as well as biology, as well as resources that can help us resolve the unsolvable. The second area will be digital equity. And digital equity is important, especially in Canada. And if we want to show how we can do that to the rest of the planet, let's start here. We've got regions that are not deserved yet. We want to make sure that we can address that. And the last one, and not the least, is clean tech. So clean tech, doing better for the planet. VMware, just a fact, VMware, you know, has saved 1.2 billion of metric tons in the world. J'ai bien dit 1.2 milliard de tonnes métriques de CO2. Alors, on est un leader, on veut travailler avec les gens, avec l'industrie, c'est un point important. On veut amener l'innovation par rapport à ces points-là. Et je vais finir en terminant une dernière annonce qu'on va faire aussi. On va faire un lab d'innovation TITRA qui va permettre de travailler ensemble avec les chercheurs, avec les industries, pour permettre d'innover et d'adresser la fracture numérique des gens. Alors, pour les jeunes qui sont ici, pour les gens qui écoutent, on va permettre la prochaine fois, peut-être dans les prochains MITAX Awards, de vous avoir en présence holographique. C'est ce que les technologies vont permettre de faire. Ça va permettre de se travailler ensemble, de pousser avec ce qu'on a. Alors, aujourd'hui, j'ai le plaisir, I have the privilege of announcing this year's winner of the MITAX Award for Outstanding Innovation PhD. This award is given to PhD student who has conducted exemplary research on MITAX-funded project. This year's award goes to Prisca Bustamante. So, Prisca, you know, she's a PhD candidate researcher at the Research Institute of the McGill University Healthcare. Her groundbreaking research has led to the world's first non-invasive blood screening test for uveal melanoma, the most common eye cancer found in adults. We need to be proud of you. Your novel test is currently being used in a clinical study at the McGill University, at the McGill Academy Eye Center, and expected to have a global impact. I'm sure that's going to be important to have Canadians that can shine around the planet. So Prisca, congratulations on winning on your exceptional contribution to science. Et ça me touche personnellement, votre travail pour les yeux. Alors, merci beaucoup, si vous voulez vous joindre à moi.
Merci, Benoît. Merci, Véronique. It's truly an honor to have been selected as a recipient of this prestigious award. I am absolutely delighted, and I cannot express my gratitude enough to my dads that made this project possible. I would like to express my most sincere and utmost gratitude to my supervisor, Dr. Julia Bournier, our partner organization, our collaborators, MATLAB colleagues, and most importantly, all patients who have participated in this study. Je suis extrêmement reconnaissante de votre participation à ce projet. As we are aware, despite correct treatments, cancer dominates too many lives. An early diagnosis can make a difference in treatment response and survival time. My research offers a screening test based on a simple blood analysis to monitor and diagnose early a highly lethal eye cancer. Unlike the current standard methods that use imaging technologies, our approach is different because we have worked on a blood test that will allow early detection and therefore early treatment. I am incredibly grateful for my TAT support and allow me to advance my skills for my career through its training program, supported my visit to our partner company in Germany, and mainly for the incredible opportunity to work in this project that ultimately aims to fight cancer. Thank you.
And we have one more video from tonight from David Lisk, who is the Vice President of National Research Council of Canada Industrial Research Advanced Program, IRAP. He has recorded this short message for us.
Hello, bonjour. I'm Dave Lisk, Vice President of the National Research Council of Canada Industrial Research Assistance Program, or better known as NRC IRAP. I'm very pleased to be joining you for the 2021 MITAX Awards Ceremony. The National Research Council is Canada's largest federal research and development organization, striving to contribute to a better Canada through excellence in research and innovation. NRC IRAP, which will be celebrating its 75th anniversary in January 2022, provides technical and business advice, connections and linkages to help Canadian small and medium-sized firms to take their ideas to market by helping them transform their innovative ideas into new products, new services, or processes that ultimately help them to grow. The program is delivered through a dedicated network of over 265 industrial technology advisors, or ITAs, in 110 locations across Canada, helping businesses succeed in all industry sectors. Every year, over 9,000 innovative SMEs receive advisory services, funding, or referrals through our ITAs to help them reach their growth potential. Our ITAs serve as trusted advisors and mentors to the business. We help them navigate technical or business hurdles and provide important linkages and advice. NRC IRAP has been a proud supporter of the MITAX Awards since 2013. The MITAX and NRC IRAP Award for Commercialization is provided each year to a student or postdoctoral fellow for an idea brought from research that is now in the market or soon will be. The fresh perspectives brought to the table by award nominees and recipients over the years have made an immeasurable difference for so many innovative companies across Canada. Please join me in congratulating this year's recipient, and indeed all recipients from today's event. Without further ado, I would now turn it back to our colleagues in the room to present this year's MITAX and NRC IRAP Award for Commercialization to our distinguished honoree. Thank you. Merci.
And on behalf of NRC, please welcome Tony Shaheen on stage.
Good evening, everyone. Bonsoir. I'm Tony Shaheen, and I am the CEO of Myint, a textile computing company based in Toronto, and I also serve on the MITAX board. I started my company sometime in 2010 because I was worried about my father, who was suffering from dementia and wanted to find it a holistic, a passive and ambient means to monitor his needs and the needs of other people with cognitive disorders, understanding they could not learn new habits or how to use new devices. Eventually, I landed on the most efficient way to do this: computers integrated into the textile we wear every single day across all our demographic. The path to commercialization, this idea was not always a smooth one. And yet, today, Myint is one of the largest and most advanced textile computing anywhere in the world. We employ over 150 skilled engineers, researchers, data scientists, and designers, and hold over 80 patents. A key part of our success was being able to draw upon the amazing researchers in Canadian universities by building strong partnership with MITAX. These partnerships demonstrated to me the value of collaborating with MITAX in order to help bridge gaps and support the development of new products. As a partner of MITAX and a member of its board, I respect and admire the organization's commitment to building real innovation, partnership from the ideation phase right through commercialization. And this is why I am so proud to present this year's MITAX Commercialization Award, sponsored by the NRC, to Arash Haddadi. Arash is being honored tonight for his breakthrough work in creating a 99% effective antimicrobial fabric coating that prevents transmission of COVID-19 while a postdoctoral research fellow at the UBC Okanagan School of Engineering. Approved by Health Canada, the coating, which combines graphene oxide and silver, is now being incorporated into millions of face masks for sale around the world. This is yet another great example of how MITAX programs can not only give valuable real-world experience to interns, but also contribute to the development of products that help people and drive economic growth. Congratulations, Arash. Thank you. Thank you so much.
I think I'm going to wrap up this great ceremony. Hello, everyone. My name is Sayed Arash Haddadi, a postdoctoral research fellow from the University of British Columbia. Thank you, Veronique, Tony, for your very kind introduction. I'm honored to receive the 2021 MITAX Award for Commercialization awarded by NRC. This award means a lot to me and encouraged me to keep up my hard work to help all communities across the world stay safer during this pandemic. In receiving this award, I am very grateful to my industrial partner, Zentech, for especially Dr. Colleen van der Koer, Dr. Francis Dube, and Mr. Greg Fenton for all their support, guidance to achieve this goal during my MyTax Elevate program. A great thanks to my supervisor, Dr. Mohammad Arjman, and all my friends at the University of British Columbia for all their support. A special thank to my amazing wife for all the encouragement and motivation to keep going and letting me to work at the weekends and holidays. In this research, we developed a novel graphene oxide silver nano ink called ZenGuard that has demonstrated extraordinary antiviral and antibacterial properties after coating the masks. As you know, wearing a mask is one of the most effective ways to protect ourselves against active airborne viral and bacterial pathogens, which can transmit from person to person through the air. The novel ink was tested to deactivate 99% or more of SARS-CoV-19 viral particles when incorporated into a mask coating. Furthermore, the coating has been measured to reduce the transmission of active pathogens through the mask by 99%. Let's continue with some good news. Thanks to nanotechnology, this developed graphene oxide silver nanomaterial is fully dispersed in water. This ink is odorless and no harmful and toxic chemicals are used in its formulation. In addition, after getting the Health Canada approval on September 21st, Zen has completed the production of 4 million masks per month. Owing to the significant global demand, Zen is planning to produce 800 million masks per month in near future. At the end, I would like to thank MyTax for providing funding for my project and this great arena to do the high quality researches, and also this golden opportunity to be a part of the global team for stopping the COVID-19 pandemic. Thanks again for receiving this award. Thank you.
Félicitations encore une fois. Merci à tous de vous être déplacés, de nous avoir écoutés à la maison. We can't finish this evening without thanking a lot of people. J'aimerais saluer les partenaires de MyTax qui jouent un rôle essentiel dans la mise en œuvre des programmes exceptionnels dont MyTax est si fier et qui sont mis en lumière ce soir. Alors merci aux partenaires financiers, le gouvernement du Canada, les gouvernements provinciaux, le gouvernement du Yukon et le réseau de partenaires industriels postsecondaires et internationaux. Et merci à l'équipe de haute direction de MyTax et au personnel, très dévoué. Vous jouez tous et toutes un rôle très important dans l'offre des programmes et ainsi vous encouragez l'innovation canadienne grâce à la recherche et au développement. Before we conclude tonight's ceremony, I would like to welcome on stage the new chair of MyTax, Philippe Gervais. Alors, Mr. Gervais is a managing principal at Navigator. He has served as chair of MyTax's board of directors since last September, and MyTax is lucky to be able to draw on his extensive experience to steer the organization as it continues to grow and fulfill its role as a key driver of innovation and economic development in Canada. Please welcome him on stage.
Merci beaucoup, Véronique, pour cette généreuse introduction. Et surtout, merci d'avoir agi comme une animatrice ce soir. Wasn't she an amazing master of ceremony? Thank you. After 10 years on the boards of MyTax, and most recently as chair, I'm very proud to serve on this for this organization, because I truly believe and deeply believe in MyTax's mission of improving productivity and stimulating economic growth through development of innovation partnerships across Canada. Ce double objectif de stimuler la productivité des entreprises canadiennes tout en exposant nos meilleurs étudiants à la recherche en entreprise et en organismes sans but lucratif est une des clés du succès économique à long terme de notre pays. The amazing researchers we have recognized tonight, those whose work span everything from the fight against climate change to fighting cancer, really to reimagining history through new lenses and new perspectives. I'm also a history fan. I learned something new today, and I look forward to reading more about that in the coming months. It's just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to the amazing collaborations that MITACS is involved in right across the country. I only wish we had more time tonight to hear more about some of these young leaders and their fantastic projects. Just remember that for every one that we heard tonight, there are hundreds of others that we helped across the country this year. 1,700 last year. 17,000, sorry, not 100, 17,000, it's a little bit more. And they all deserve a prize. The strength of the students and postgraduates in our network, the mentorship of our academic partners, and the spirit and know-how of our industry partners has helped us chart a course for continued growth. Before we break for the evening, I would like to say a few thank yous on behalf of the organization and board. Premièrement, un gros merci au gouvernement du Canada, qui est représenté ici par M. le ministre Champagne, pour sa confiance, ses investissements soutenus. Vous êtes un partenaire irremplaçable et, comme on l'a vu tout à l'heure, très enthousiaste. Donc, merci, merci beaucoup pour tout ce que vous faites pour nous. Et ensemble, on va faire des grandes choses. On va continuer à faire des grandes choses. Merci aux 10 provinces canadiennes et au gouvernement du Yukon. Vous êtes des partenaires cruciaux et importants pour le développement de MITACS. Merci à nos partenaires académiques, les universités, les collèges. A lot of them are here today, so colleges and universities, thank you. We had a working session this afternoon with you, and I think it was worth spending that time. And something we'll repeat, right, John? It was a great working session. So thank you for your partnership and your help. Merci aussi à nos partenaires internationaux et nous, qui sont essentiels et surtout nos partenaires industriels et sans but lucratif qui sont vraiment la maille qui amène tout ça ensemble. Lastly, thank you to our distinguished guests and presenters and everyone who tuned in online today. Thank you all. Ce fut un réel plaisir de rendre hommage aux récipiendaires des prix MITACS. Again, congratulations to all the winners tonight. There are no more prizes left, so there's good and bad news. That means it's the end of the evening, so thank you very much. That's the good news. The bad news is, once again, some of us tonight will be leaving without a prize. But I hope you make it home safe. Thank you all, et bonne soirée.